Now, we have the UN Convention of Geneva of 1940, and this is a very important tool on the requirements of observation of war or during war. We also appreciate that many of our countries are signatories to this convention. As parliamentarians, we must make sure or we must ensure that our governments, even those which are affected by war, really observe this very important instrument, UN instrument. Secondly, we must also now campaign that during when UN is organizing peace missions, it must at least have a representative of women, because we know very well that the most affected people during conflict are women. At least a third, we should demand that at least a third of those peace missions must comprise of women. We appreciate where they have been able to send women to at least bring in the values of women during war. I want also to add that we must continue to campaign against rape as a tool of war. This is already captured within the UN security documents, but we must maybe demand that UN periodically produces reports on the way how this very important offense or crime has been averted. Because we know still that in many of the war areas, this is still used as a tool of war. I want maybe also to add that where regional mechanisms exist, UN should work with those regional mechanisms, particularly, for instance, where there are regional assemblies, regional parliaments, for instance, in Africa and with the AU, African Union, within the East African region, we do have the International Great Lakes Region Conference, ICGRL, which has been very instrumental in proposing mechanism which we can really avert war. We want to urge UN to work closely with these regional blockings, groupings, so that we are able to avert war. And I want maybe to add, as I conclude, that we must be able to also request the international humanitarian agencies to include a women's desk in their relief supplies, which would specifically look towards the needs of women during war. Those are my submissions.